Hello, and welcome to this iSystem Debug Workshop video. Today's topic is the Callstack Window in winIDEA. We will take a look at what it does, how to use it, and how it helps us in the debugging process. When we stop at a breakpoint, we obviously know which function we stopped in, but it is often useful to also know the sequence of events that has led us to this point. For example, the same function can be called from various points in the application, and if we know which function calls preceded our current stopping point, it gives us more insight into the current state of the system that we're debugging. This is exactly the function of the Callstack window and the information it conveys. From top to bottom, it lists the function nesting history from the current statement to the beginning of the program. Function names are shown on the left, while the source line numbers at which the next function call occurred are listed on the right. Let's take a look at how this works in practice. I have a winIDEA workspace open, and I have an application running on an Rx target. We can open the Callstack window by selecting View, and then Debug Callstack. Let's move the window to a suitable location. We can set a breakpoint in a function, and the execution is now stopped at this breakpoint. If we take a look at the Callstack window, we can see the entire Callstack from the beginning of the execution up to this point. So, we started in start, then the main function got called, then the temperature read function was called, and finally the temperature sensor read function call was executed, which is where we are now. If we double-click on an item, a green arrow indicating the execution point will appear in the source view. In addition, all other debugging windows, like the local variables and register values, will be set to that item's context. This functionality is also available from the drop-down menu at the top of the Locals window, which can also be used as a sort of mini Callstack view. The way the Callstack window acquires the information necessary for it to work is highly dependent on the compiler in use. There is a specific setting in winIDEA that covers the different methods used for this. We can access it by clicking Debug, Files for Download, pressing the Edit button, and selecting Advanced. Here we have an option called Callstack Generation, and by default, it's set to Automatic. In the vast majority of cases, this automatic setting works without issues, but in case the Callstack window is behaving incorrectly, you can try one of the other three settings and it will most likely work. Another thing to check is your compiler settings, especially when using the Green Hills compiler. Please refer to our website for additional information on how to set that up. That's it for today's video. You should now be familiar with what the Callstack window does and how it can help you in the debugging process. See you next time!